So, hi everybody, my name is Jean-Claude Martin. They call me JC here in South Africa. I'm Swiss-born winemaker. Was running a wine estate in Neuchâtel. It's in the western part of Switzerland. And then had this idea to move on in my life. Bought this sheep farm here in South Africa and started a project from scratch. That was now nearly 20 years ago. One of the reasons why we did that is I married my South African wife, Caroline, who was alongside on that journey. She is from a wine family background, from the Finlayson family, who was running several wine estates in South Africa. And so we're doing that now here together. I'm more the person for the vineyards and the winery. Caroline keeps everything on track on the marketing side and the sales. And so we have quite a good teamwork together and normally quite a lot of fun together to work on the same place. So the location of this wine estate creation is in the Hemlen Arden Valley or Heaven and Earth Valley. It's right on the coastlines, close to the most southern point of the continent. The little town who is at the sea is Hermanus, and then that valley stretches up for around 25 kilometers alongside the coastlines into the slightly higher altitude. So we relocated pretty much on top of that valley at around 300 meters above sea level, still very close proximity to the sea, the ocean. And the reason why I mentioned that is the ocean is pretty much our big fridge. So the ocean is the whole year around 12 to 14 degrees. The most prevailing winds coming from the ocean side, and that means this terroir here where we're working with, from the temperature wise, is very cool climate, not just here in South Africa, actually on a world context in winemaking. That is one of the main reasons why we ended up to producing mainly Pinot Noir in this valley and Chardonnay. But we have the luxury that we can produce climatically also slightly warmer cultivars because the weather stays on for a long time very good till up to April. So when we once finishing off our harvest of Chardonnay Pinot Noir, then we're heading 2-3 weeks later for our Rhone cultivars. So we have quite a bit of Rhone whites between Roussan, Marsan, Viognier, Grenache Blanc. And then also on the reds, the Syrah Grenache, who sometimes we combine in a blend or we make single Syrah. So on the winemaking side, we make little intervention winemaking. Someone just told me recently it becomes nearly a swear word because everybody uses it now left and right. But this is pretty much true reflection what we do. We go with wild yeast on the ferments. We do not using any fining. We on red wines would avoid any filtering. There's no enzymes added or any tannins or whatsoever you can add in the whole catalog of products in winemaking. The good thing for us who plays in our hands, most of the vineyards is now 20 years old. It's virus free, so we don't have leaveroll virus. We have healthy plants. And we believe when the quality of the grapes reaches a certain level, then it really should be the grape, the expression of the place, make all the talk. And you as a winemaker, you will just guide that process in a way that it stays on a good track.